mayong udto kanatong tanan. My dear friends, in this season of Lent, in which we are enjoined to go on this beautiful journey of spiritual nourishment, it is somehow our way to assess where we are now in our life of holiness, in our relationship with God and others, of where we are now in our desire to live a life pleasing before the eyes of God. And this is all about this Lenten season. Sa kanunay, pagpaninguha nga makapuyo unta kita diha sa pagkabalaan. And yet in today's gospel, it teaches us one important aspect of how it is to be holy, of how it is to live a holy life. That to be holy is not about to be perfect, not to be externally someone who doesn't seem to know what sin is all about. Makaingunta nga kining tawhana, dagway ini, balaan kayo, murag anghel, di makabuak og baso pero makabuak og pitsil, no? And yet, the calling of holiness is not about the presentation of the externalities, but it is more in one's capacity to love. What holiness is all about our capacity of loving. The more that we are, or we have to love, or the more we heed the calling of love, then the more that we are holy. Kaya ang pagkabalaan, maura yun ang pagsunod sa Ginoo diha sa lakang sa paghigugma. When the Lord teaches us that we must be holy as the Heavenly Father is holy and teaches us the image of God who is love, then therefore, holiness is very much intertwined on how we respond to the calling of love. And holiness is not also about, and not only about, avoiding sinfulness, avoiding sins. But of course, it is also important, but it's not all about that. Nga di ta makasa, ug aron ta mahimong balaan. We have to sanitize ourselves in all the sinful tendencies in order for us that we will be holy. And the gospel teaches us that it's not just about that. The story of the poor Lazarus and the rich Timaeus would display to us that holiness is more than just avoiding sin. Kay si Timaeus, wa man siya gibuhat nga bati ni Lazarus. Wa niya papahawaa, samtang nagkaon sa mumho, wa gani niya gipapahit sa iro, no? Wa gani niya giabog, apan niya lang gipasagan. And later on in the story, we are told that the rich man who enjoyed life of abundance while living still on earth, of eating sumptuous food, no? Kada adlaw, food grab, delivery, no? Wa abtig buwan na hospital kay nasakit. And yet, there is something more than this. It is Timaeus' failure to love. It is Timaeus' failure to lift up the condition of this poor man in the name of love. That is his failure. That what makes him to a life of torment after life. Kung mao kini ato ang timanan nga diha sa tong pagsunod sa Ginoo pagkabalaan, dili lang ni nga magsigita og likay og kahigayunan sa pagpakasa, apan to build love in our lifetime. Of how much we build love in our families, in our neighbors, in the community that we are, that is the measure of holiness. And that what makes us pleasing before the Lord. For God is a God of love. And when we are invited to Him, we partake this invitation to love. Amen.